Good day, everyone. My name is Jewel. This is a very quick tropical update this morning, Friday, the 5th of June, 2020. I will do my best to have a more extensive forecast a little bit later on today. But now, as we see Cristobal over here, the winds are 35 miles per hour at the time, pressure 1,000 millibars. It's moving northeast, picking up speed. Once it picks us, keeps picking the speed up, once it gets out over the water, it will start to intensify, moving north-northeast this morning at 7 miles per hour. It took it a while to pick up speed. That's why the coastal sections of the Gulf Coast didn't receive those watches last night, but they're coming, folks. Right now, the tropical storm watch is up over the eastern Yucatan Peninsula, as you can see here in the yellow. Now, this is going to strengthen once it does get up out of that water, and it's trying right now. The winds should probably get up to 60 miles per hour while it's out in the water. We do have a system over here. I'm not going to go into all of that. It should come up pretty close to the Mississippi Panhandle, but the system's looking like going to push it slightly back over into Louisiana, and we'll check some of that out in just a moment. One thing about this storm, I said yesterday, it just don't want to die out completely by Wednesday. You can see up here in Illinois and around St. Louis, Wednesday, you guys can still have winds as of now of 30 miles per hour and very, very heavy rain. So it's going to be spreading rain everywhere. Of course, we all know it can bounce anywhere within this cone, but this is generally what it's looking like with the systems over here and over here. And also, we have one coming down over here now. This is the way the track is going to go for the most part. The rain is going to be a big issue because it can cause some flash flooding. And as you can see right in here, at least 2 inches of rain over a large portion of Florida. This is just what it's looking like now. This will change as the storm moves a little more. But, I mean, over here in Louisiana, in the very tip of the Mississippi Panhandle, that's 6 inches of rain or more. 6 inches of rain or more in this area. You guys over here can have 2 inches easily. You might even have 3. And when these rains start, they can cause flash flooding. Please be aware. And as we move this map just a little, you can see how this is going to start to go up into Illinois. Once it hits land and gets up, these graphs will change. You'll see more rain headed your way. For everybody along the Gulf Coast from Louisiana down around all the way through Florida on the West Coast, you guys should start to see maybe watches coming up later this evening or tonight. It just stalled over where it was down here in this area of the Yucatan Peninsula, but now it started to move. It looked like it was going to move before that. That's why yesterday I said you guys would have it. And the National Hurricane Center thought you would have them sooner also. But they are coming, so be aware. I have this over on the European model right now. I'm going to turn it on. Just let it roll through. And you're going to see how it will intensify. It doesn't matter what model you use. This is really what it looks like it's going to do for most models at this time. You can see how it's spinning around. The wind should get up to around 60 miles per hour while it's out in the water, but once it hits land, looking like it should die to 50 mile per hour winds. But no one can be certain of this right now, and it still could change its path depending on the systems and how they come in to help steer this system. So, anywhere you see Louisiana all the way to the Florida Big Bend area, be on the outlook and look at all of this heavy, heavy rain that's coming in. Big time rain coming in. I want to stop this right now for a moment, and I'm going to make this map a little bigger. And we're going to come over here like this, and we can see some areas, you can see all of this rain, okay? Lots and lots and lots of rain. Tampa, you're going to get lots and lots and lots of rain off and on in this, and it's going to creep up this coast as you saw during the time length there. Now, I want to make it just a little bigger one more time for you so we can see where the center of circulation is right here. And we will check the wind field. Doesn't necessarily mean this is what it's going to be, but no matter what, the wind is going to bring in storm surge, as you can see, right up in this area. Now, this is Sunday around 4 p.m. as we move it over. Everybody who lives in this area, the wind, what wind there is going to make the water get higher. You are will probably have some type of storm surge going on. When we click over to the wind gust, that's a whole different story. Everybody down here, especially around the borderline here, moving on up in Florida, panhandle down here in Mobile area, also in these areas here, you can actually see some of the dry shear wind mixed in with it, as I've showed you. We'll click on this. That's 32 mile per hour wind gust. Now, and when we come over to around Mobile, let's check out these wind gusts, 47 miles per hour. This is going to really stir the water up, and you're going to have a chance of some flash flooding with this. Now, when we get out in the water like I've talked about, yep, the wind's going to be much stronger. This is at 56 mile per hour wind gusts. Sustained winds, though, as you can see, aren't quite as bad. Still pretty steep. On this eastern quadrant of the storm is where the most rain and the most wind is, and they're steady at 38 miles per hour. Doesn't mean that's exactly what they're going to be. This is just to give you a general idea. Now, I'll bring this down just a little bit to show you something right quick as we move this up here like this. I'm going to turn it back on. The center is still out in the Gulf. This is the center, but watch what happens. Looks like it's going to go in right there. Okay? And move right on up, but mostly right around this area. Let's stop it now. This is where all of the higher winds, I should say, and the rain bands and maybe the storm surge should take place. We'll come up back just a little bit more because I do want to show you this. This is what it looks like right now. And once again, this is just the European model. It still can bounce anywhere from over here to over here, but this is looking pretty much in accordance with the other global models at this time. Over around New Orleans, around Biloxi, all right up in here. This is the wind again, but let's put it on the rain. Look at those rain bands, very, very heavy rain bands that are going to be whipping around up in these areas around Mobile and Biloxi all along. Center still out here. We'll click it just really quick now. Now the center seems to be on land right up in here. So we'll make this just a little bit bigger so you can see where it looks like it may occur. So I'm saying anywhere. And I don't know if you guys remember or not, but last year there was a tropical storm and Morgan City got pounded with rain. Everybody else was pretty dry the whole time, but Morgan City got pounded with the rain. So looks like Morgan City could still get some. And this is the center of circulation right here. So somewhere in this area as of now, doesn't mean it's going to stay this way, but sometime late Sunday night, early hours of Monday morning, Cristobal should come in, and it's looking like Louisiana. I would not rule out the panhandle down here around Mississippi either at this time. Either way, Mississippi, you're going to get lots of rain. you're going to probably have some storm surge, even if it's just a little bit all the way from Louisiana to the Big Bend area of Florida. So that's a check of it right now. I'll have a complete update later on after we get some more information today as these things change with the different system movements and at the rate they move. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. I love you guys. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.